Hey everybody, welcome back to A Better Computer. My name is Matt, and this right here is a new computer. And it's a rare opportunity on this channel to jump into a completely new medium for software, but that's what we're doing today with Apple's first foray into VR, AR, MR, whatever you want to call it. They have a new headset out that can do some cool stuff. And we're not going to talk about the headset itself today. There's plenty of people who have done that. I'm not going to even show myself on camera wearing it. I'm certainly not going to wear it for 24 hours. My fellow YouTubers, please stop. You don't need to wear it for 24 hours. But what we're going to do today is the same thing we always do on this channel, and that's look at software running on the product and seeing how it works and seeing if it's worth your time and money. So I couldn't think of a better place to start than looking at Things, which is my task manager of choice. I've made plenty of videos on how the app works in general, but today I want to take a look at how it works in virtual reality and mixed reality. And yeah, let's see how they've done with this initial release. I will say that because Things has a weird business model compared to basically every other app out there, you pay individually for each platform you have it on. So I think it's $10 on the iPhone, $20 on the iPad, $50 on the Mac, and it's going to be another $30 US to get it on the Vision Pro. So even if you have it on all the other places, you do have to buy it again. I did buy it with my own money for this video, so let's jump in. Okay, so here we are at my desk, and I'm actually recording through the microphones in the Vision Pro, which are excellent. I think this sounds really good. I'm really impressed by them. But yeah, we're at my Mac, and this is no way to use it. It looks bad to you. It looks better to me, but it's not good by any means. So let's go ahead and get our messy desk out of the way. And I'm going to go to about 60%, which for me is a good working immersion because my field of view has this nice environment. I'm using Joshua Tree, but I can still see my keyboard if I look down, and my rest of the world is still visible off to the sides. But I can't see my display, right? That's gone. So I'm going to bring up Control Center over here. I'm going to go to Mac Virtual Display. And we're not doing a review of Vision OS, but I'm looking at things, I'm focusing on things with my eyes, and then I'm pinching with my fingers to move things, resize them. And yeah, you can go pretty big if you want. You can move it backwards, you can move it forwards. We're just going to go with this, and we'll actually make it a little smaller, I think. But here we go. Now I'm using my Mac, and I can go ahead and just do all the normal things, like new thing. There we go, I've got a new task. I could move it over to the morning project if I want, but I don't want to do that yet. So let's move the Mac off to the side. I'm going to look over here and press the top button, and my list of apps comes up and I can scroll through them, but Things is right here. And I'm going to grab the bottom and kind of move it next to the Mac display. I can resize this as well to whatever I'd like. I'm going to do kind of like this. But yeah, you can see they're totally in sync. And what's cool is because I have my Mac connected and I'm using my keyboard and mouse, if I go to New Thing and select the Notes field, I can use the virtual keyboard, which is okay. Or I can actually use my normal keyboard. This is okay. This is much better. So when you're connected to a Mac, any peripherals you have connected to that are able to work in your Vision OS environment. So there we go. We can do that. And if I want to move this, I can actually drag as well. So I'm focusing, you can see as I move my eyes around, I'm focusing on different things. But if I want to grab new thing, drag it over to morning. Now it's in the morning project. If I want to move it to this evening, I can select it, go to today, do this evening. There we go. And now it's a thing to do this evening. And so, yeah, it works like Things. If we go into the settings, a lot of the things are here. Things Cloud is here, calendar events. You can put those at the top if you want. Reminders, importing Siri suggestions, shortcuts info, general settings. You can change when you badge the icon. If we kind of go back, you can see Things does have a badge. Badges are supported in Vision OS. And yeah, you can look back at the Mac and see that it moved new thing to the morning project that's happening this evening, which is a little confusing. You can see I have a notification that came in from my calendar app on the screen right now, which is very convenient. Definitely wanted to see that while I was recording. But yeah, you can close this down, mark it as complete. There you go. And then we should see over there in a second, it syncs over. So everything works great. It's a really good implementation on Vision OS. And yeah, I'm going to work on making my recordings higher quality. It's a little limiting right now on Vision OS, but I'll do my best to make these videos look the best they can going forward. But wanted to get a quick video out showing you guys Things 3 and how it works.